Hey everyone, and this is Senpai. Today we are going to compare an old Yandere Simulator 2015 build to the current 2020 demo version. And if you're new to this channel, please consider subscribing because it will really make my day so much better. Now let's proceed to the video. Yandere Simulator doesn't receive any significant graphic updates over the course of 5 years. Everything still looks rather the same, except the color. The color on the demo looks nicer thanks to the color grading from the game. In the 2015 build, every time you want to change the graphic setting, you have to quit the game and change it manually on the launcher. The graphic setting varies. If you pick fastest, the game will look ugly without any shadow and low quality texture. If you pick good, then the graphic quality will increase. It adds shadow, but the shadow still looks choppy. The Yandere setting is basically the max setting on the newer version. In the demo, you can change the graphic setting in-game, although there is still an option to choose the graphic setting on the startup. The in-game setting provides more graphics options to choose from, making it easier for players with slow computer to properly enjoy the game. This is the comparison between the highest and the lowest setting. This is the old version. It looks plain, it looks simple, but if you press the space button, and this is the new version. It looks much, much cleaner. Also, the main menu appearance is affected by the player's action. If Ayana-chan kills someone, instead of a love letter in her hand, it will change into a bloody knife. If Ayana-chan eliminates Osana by killing her, her body will appear on the back, and her body appearance depends on how you eliminate her. The changes also apply to school atmosphere too. If the school atmosphere drops below 60%, the main menu appearance and the music will also change. Ayane-chan's room used to look small and dark, as if it's nighttime all the time. This might explain the absence of nighttime activity in Ayane's room. When the school ended, the day simply skipped into the next date. In the demo version, Ayane-chan's room looks bigger with more features as well. Both old and demo were able to do the same things, such as changing panties, pinning picture on the cupboard, and staring at Senpai Shrine. With the addition of the demo version is the ability to watch anime. The newer version also adds nighttime activities such as playing games, reading manga, and computers. The basement also received cosmetic changes. It has 3 different versions. In the old Yandere Simulator, as you can see, the town is bigger. It feels like an actual town instead of single street like the current Yandere Simulator is. Although it's bigger, there's actually nothing you can do except cycling around. Unlike the old version, the demo version is cleaner and much more simpler with just a single street with 8 different stores and different shopkeepers too. You can interact with them by purchasing items from them. Let's talk about frame rates. Yandere Simulator is infamous for its bad frame rates for years. Frame rates in 2015 Yandere build is obviously better because it has less model, features and NPC, unlike the current Yandere Simulator is. In the Yandere Simulator demo, however, the frame rate is much better than the previous 2019 and 2020 debug builds. But everything is not perfect yet. There's still many like spikes that need to be fixed. For example, when you pull out a weapon from the inventory, the frame rate will drop by 10 to 20 FPS. Now here's my favorite. The old school looks rather plain, it's a simple light colored gray, empty room and awkwardly empty space. The school oddly looks similar to Persona 4 school. The new school, however, got a massive makeover. The school is now twice the size of the old school with decorated halls, invisible glass, club room with actual props and just a general improvement. The new school also has more students with different personalities, with a total of 78 students, including Ayane-chan. This is another comparison between the old school and the new school. Let's cover the outer part of the school area. In the old build, there is only a gym and a bathhouse. The old gym texture is not original and that's why it's changed on the newer version. The bathhouse doesn't receive many changes, only some minor decoration and new shower room to avoid nudity. The demo version received several makeover and some new building. The school now feels like an actual school with the added pool, garden, Japanese traditional decoration, small plaza, and a maze. Sound design in a video game is just as important as the graphics, storyline, and the gameplay itself. Yandere Simulator received a lot of new sound effects and music over the course of 5 years. There are only 2 background music in 2015 build, whereas in the 2020 demo, there are 10 background music, and every background music has 9 different versions, making it 90 background music. Sound effects that didn't exist in 2015 builds, such as footstep, now exist in the demo version, making it much more immersive. I think this one is self-explanatory. Take a look.
Excuse me. Would you please stop doing that? You're scaring me.
No. Wait. He knows the truth about me. If I can't have you, no one can.
This is Osana, or at least that's what we thought. And this is Osana on the demo. Finally, after all this year, Osana is released. It's such a huge progress from this to this. Is 6 years a long time just to finish the demo? Yes, it's beyond long. Does Yandere Simulator still have a future? In my opinion, it depends. The game itself has many potential to be a great game. With more effort from the team and Yandere dev, the game might be finished and gives us a wonderful experience. For now, it's very unclear on how Yandere Simulator future is. What do you guys think about the Yandere Simulator future? Will it survive in a couple years from now on? Or will it fail because the tremendous amount of hate that Yandere dev keeps getting? I'm interested in hearing your actual thought. As long as it's well argumented, I'm looking forward to reading it. Anyway, thank you for watching this video. Give this video a thumbs up if you like it. And one thing to note, I am not a native speaker. I'm sorry if there are any grammar mistakes or bad pronunciation. And please leave your thought about my accent in the comment section down below. And follow my Twitter at senpaiz1. That's all for today's video, and I'll see you again very, very soon. Adios.